Okay, it's 5 o'clock now, so let's start our webinar about China's agrochemicals market right now. Hello and welcome to K-Commerce webinar about China's agrochemicals market. This presentation will give you an overview on the current market situation, provide an outlook for the development in the near future, and demonstrate some tools for your own effective market research in China. I am Patrick, and I am very happy to guide you through today's webinar. Please be noted, you can write down any questions during the presentation in the chat box, and there I can gather them all and answer you per email back to the questions. At the beginning, first have a look at the agenda of the presentation today. I start with introducing you the sources for China's agrochemicals market research in form of newsletters and reports. And I introduce you our company, K-Comber, in general. Then we will have a close look on China's agrochemicals market, including the price, production, some challenges, and the overall development. This will give me the chance to also show you CCM's price analysis tool at a glance. After that, we continue with a look at the R&D situation and an import and export analysis of pesticides in China, and therefore introducing our trade analysis platform. After analyzing the top market players in China, the presentation then will end with an outlook on China's pesticides and fertilizer development in the near future. The market research on China's agrochemicals market can be found in CCM's monthly newsletters like Herbicides China News, Fungicides China News, Insecticides China News, Glyphosate China Monthly Report, and Phosphorus Industry China Monthly Report. These newsletters keep the reader updated on the specific industry in China, including information like market news, price, company and politics dynamics, as well as any newsworthy stories of the market. For a broader analysis, I recommend CCM's industrial reports. For example, the financial performance of Chinese listed pesticide enterprises, China Pesticide Technical Price Report, the top 100 pesticide enterprises in China, a survey of the pesticide industry in China, or the China Phosphorus Industry Market Report. For official import and export customs trade data around the world, our trade analysis brand Trenalysis offers the raw data as well as customized manufacturer-to-buyer analysis of plenty agrochemical commodities. So, you may be wondering what qualifies me to talk about China's agrochemicals markets. That's why I'd like to introduce you our company K-Comber first. K-Comber is a business and market intelligence company based in Guangzhou in the south of China. The enterprise provides leading knowledge management solutions for business intelligence, market research, and big data controlling. Part of the technology-driven solutions are a global trade analytics platform, various company data applications, and China's largest archive for agrochemicals market research. K-Comber is running mainly through the two brands CCM and Trenalysis. CCM is the agrochemicals market research and intelligence brand of K-Comber, dedicated since 2001 to providing international and domestic companies both with unique and premium insights in China's hardly transparent agrochemicals market. The brand becomes especially known to be the main source for many global players for China's glyphosate situation in the background of international discussions and China's leadership in production and export of this major herbicide in the world. Trenalysis is K-Comber's import and export analysis brand, gathering the original agrochemicals trade data from customs all over the world. Trenalysis researches the manufacturers and end consumers behind the traders and provides on this way valuable information for clients to be better prepared for negotiations of business partners, find new areas to invest, and manage their overall global supply chain. After introducing our company and main brands, let me now come to the topic you are all waiting for and talk about the agrochemical situation in China. So, what is happening in China's agrochemical industry? With over 60 years of steady development, China has become the worldwide biggest production base of pesticides. China's pesticide output had kept an uptrend from 2010 to 2015 with a CAGR of 9.81%, reaching 3.74 million tons in 2015. Meanwhile, its output value grew at a CAGR of about 12.8%, hitting $42.8 billion in the same year. In 2016, China's total output of pesticide technical reached about 3.78 million tons, up by almost 1% compared with that from 2015. Hence, the market remained flat. Notably, in the years 2012 to 2016, it has been growing at an average year-on-year rate of 1.47%. Of the whole pesticide industry, the output of herbicides was accounted for almost 47% of all. However, there are still many problems in China's pesticide industry, such as overcapacity, inefficient production technologies, capital shortage, few well-known brands, and a serious environmental pollution. Chinese pesticide producers have been facing increasing production costs in China, which results from the increased environmental pressure by the government conducting regular inspections. China's most important province in terms of pesticide production is Jiangsu province, located north of Shanghai. In the economically strong east region of China, this province is responsible for about 40% of the total pesticide output in China alone, producing around 550,000 tons each year. What's more, the government is modernizing the agricultural production by limiting and banning the use of high toxic pesticides to develop into an environmental friendly cultivation method. According to CCM, there are 39 pesticides that are completely banned for the use in China, and more are restricted to only be used for dedicated crops. Notably, most of the banned pesticides in China are insecticides. China's domestic market, as well as the international pesticides market, furthermore are struggling with adversities like sluggish demand, bans on an increasing number of pesticides, and a significant oversupply. In the first half of 2017, the ex-works prices of fungicide technical showed a rising trend as a whole in China. During the second quarter of 2017, prices of most fungicide products rose due to the rising demand. In July, prices of fungicide technical turned to a downturn with a reduced demand from downstream. The capacity of fungicide manufacturers may not be effectively released because of the fourth round environmental inspection carried out in China, and the prices of fungicide products are expected to further rise. The export prices of most herbicides, in the contrast, remain stable, even some of them fluctuated a little in China. In the second quarter of 2017, the export prices of insecticides technical showed a slight upward trend as a whole in China. Specifically, the prices of 97% imidacloprid technical and 95% acetamiprid technical had reached new peaks since 2008 and 2014 respectively. However, prices of some insecticides technical showed a downward trend in the meantime, such as 95% chlorpyrifos technical and 90% foxim technical. The first 7 months of 2017 witnessed a year-on-year increase of 4.2% of the chemicals industry value added. China produced 39.71 million tons of fertilizers in total during January to July 2017, down by 5.4% year-on-year. Of them, the output of nitrogen fertilizer declined by 10.4% year-on-year, but that of both phosphate fertilizer and potassium fertilizer grew by 4.5% year-on-year. The production cost of phosphate fertilizer increased due to the climbing prices of electricity, coke, and sulfur. In terms of exports, overcapacity in the international fertilizer market worsened, and China's phosphate fertilizer exporters, who were supported by cancellation of export tariffs, had to compete with overseas counterparts who enjoyed smaller production costs. As for China's phosphate fertilizer market, the average price in the first quarter of 2017 rebounded from the bottom of the second half of 2016. While both the demand and price of phosphate fertilizer dropped down in the second quarter of 2017 as the market entered the slack season. Overall, the phosphate fertilizer industry slightly recovered from 2016, but still remained weak in China. CCM's online platform, as I said before, is China's largest archive of premium insights on various niche markets in China. It is a big data-based market intelligence platform that enables clients to take advantage of market intelligence and get ahead in the business environment. Using technology and artificial intelligence to replace human desk research in the agricultural industry. The platform includes an industry database, price forecast, macro agriculture map of China, company matching, and portrait. So you could use the price analysis function for your own price research of agrochemicals in China. It is a tool that enables users to compare price trends of agrochemical products in different countries, regions, and also for different enterprises. Furthermore, users can forecast the next 3 month price, the innovative price analysis model of CCM. The analysis is additionally backed up with related price data of CCM and external news, as well as videos, which are crawled from reliable news websites around the world. This enables not only a quick price overview and forecast, but also reveals the reason behind the price changes to let users understand the situation comprehensively. That leads us looking further into the investments into research and development in China. It's worth noting that the number of new registrations obtained by foreign enterprises in 2016 was the same as that in 2015, while the number of new registrations obtained by domestic enterprises decreased sharply in 2016. What's more, among the 12 firstly registered pesticide technical, 8 were registered by multinational corporations, and only 4 were registered by domestic ones, which can be seen that the foreign enterprises surpass domestic enterprises in the research and development of pesticide technical. According to statistics from 86 pesticides with independent innovation, going from 1995 to November 2016, totally 37 research units are involved in the research of invention of new pesticides. Among these, in terms of the number of pesticides invented by the research unit, Shenyang Research Institute of Chemical Industry ranked the first with 14 pesticides, followed by Zhejiang Research Institute of Chemical Industry and Central China Normal University, having registered 6 new pesticides. The research and development is a crucial factor for China to meet the strict quality and safety requirements for the food. It also supports a better reputation of Chinese manufacturers to ensure the acceptance in export markets. Both the Chinese government as well as the domestic manufacturers are fully aware of the importance of innovative pesticide development and have increased their investment in the R&D section significantly. In the first half of 2017, the total research and development investment of the 20 main listed pesticide enterprises in China hit $122.54 million. That's up by 33.26% year on year. Among them, 2 recorded year on year drops in their R&D investment. The top 3 enterprises by R&D investment in China were Huapont Life Science, Jiangsu Yangnong, and Zhejiang Runza. Let's talk about the trade, let's say, import and export situation in China. China is the worldwide largest exporter of pesticides, supplying countries all around the world with comparable cheap agrochemicals. The main export destinations are Brazil and the USA. Statistics from the China Customs showed that from 2014 to 2016, China's exports of pesticides has witnessed an upward trend in volume, while the imports of pesticides were in a downward trend. Specifically, the exports of herbicides have the same trend with pesticides from 2014 to 16. The import volume and export volume of herbicides herbicides among pesticides accounted for 25% and 68.88% of the total import volume and export volume in 2016. China's import volume and value of pesticides decreased in 2016, reaching 85,000 tons and $673 million respectively. While its export volume and value increased to 1.4 million tons and $3.7 billion, up by almost 20% and 4.79% year on year. Notably for exports, new rules have been stipulated in the registration of pesticides in China, affecting retail of pesticides and legal liabilities. For the registration of pesticides, according to Article 7 of the new regulations on pesticide administration, domestic and overseas pesticide enterprises shall apply for pesticides registrations. According to Article 11, overseas pesticide enterprises shall prepare the experiment report, sample label, pesticide products quality standards and methods of testing, sample pesticides, as well as material showing the registration and use in other countries or regions. For the retail of pesticides in China, it's notable that overseas enterprises must not sell pesticides on their own. Instead, they shall either establish retailing organizations or cooperate with a Chinese agency. Moreover, pesticides that are exported to China shall be equipped with Chinese labels and instructions. It is prohibited to import pesticides without any registration certificates. And for the legal liabilities, any overseas pesticide enterprises that do not abide by relevant rules and sell the pesticides directly in China shall be punished with illegal gains. Involved pesticides and relevant equipment will be confiscated. A fine of several thousand US dollar or 10 up to 20 times as much of the profit that has been achieved shall also be imposed to the enterprises. In addition, anyone who exports fake or counterfeit pesticides shall be revoked registrations of corresponding pesticides and be not allowed to apply for any registration in the next 5 years. While talking about the imports and exports in China, let me also shortly introduce our trade analysis platform. It's called IEWizard. IEWizard is the connectivity and automation tool for raw trade data. Based on the worldwide customs import and export information, IEWizard connects all related commodities and enterprises in the agricultural sector in real trade flows and visualizes the results in immediate, usable, and adaptable charts for convenient trade analysis. The online platform uses the most authoritative customs data that is used in most of customs statistics. All the data can be verified in official channels and are up-to-date received by first hand. The data is synchronized with official updates to help the user keep always be aware of market changes. In the product analysis, users can choose the commodity they want to analyze. They can choose which segment of trade they want to get analyzed by the system. Choosable segments are analyzing manufacturers, the market, traders of agrochemicals, the buyers, the country of origin or of destination of imports and exports, the transportation mode, like shipping by air, by land, the shipping ports, and the origin or destination places for use in China. So, when opening the company analysis, it will firstly show a map of the world with the countries that are colored by the number of enterprises which are registered by the system and located inside. Notice, as this is the company analysis section, it will show all companies of whatever agrochemical commodities have added into the account. Users can see a list of all the companies below the world map and they can be analyzed in the sections when they are added to the system. Or the users can also just search directly for the company they want to get analyzed by filling out the form on our website. Let's continue to talk about the major players in China's market. China's pesticide production is mainly concentrated in East China, including Jiangsu, Shandong, Henan, and Zhejiang provinces. In terms of both, the number of producers and tonnage, with a subtotal output contributing nearly 70% to the national total pesticide output. Thereinto, Shandong and Jiangsu provinces are the most important regions for the China pesticide production. In China, the total number of pesticide producers was estimated to be over 4,000 in the year 2015. The total fund for new product research of the whole pesticide industry in China is no more than 0.07 billion US dollar annually, which is, of course, much less than that of even like a single multinational player like Bayer Crop Science, which annual expenditure on innovation reaches like 0.6 billion US dollar. The total combined pesticide revenue of the top 100 pesticide enterprises in China reached 16.55 billion US dollar in 2016. That's a year-on-year decrease of 0.77%. While the total pesticide formulation revenue of the top 30 pesticide formulations enterprises was 2.16 billion US dollar. That is even a decrease by 12.34% year-on-year. The CCPAI, the organizer of the AgroChem X 2017 in China, has published a list of the top 100 pesticide enterprises in China in terms of their pesticide revenue in 2016. As revealed by the statistics in the 2017 list, there was a large polarization in the enterprises' pesticide revenues, caused by a poor industry development, strict environmental regulations, policies on power grid, and mergers and acquisitions among the enterprises. 39 enterprises achieved a pesticide revenue that is more than 150.6 million US dollar. Besides, the total pesticide revenue of the top 10 enterprises reached 4.82 billion US dollar in 2016. That's an uptrend by almost 4% year on year. The first and second rank on the list of the top 100 enterprises in China, they have both climbed two or three ranks respectively, compared to the year 2016. Those two companies are Nutrigem and Shandong Weifang Rainbow. Nutrigem is also the only Chinese pesticide manufacturer with a pesticide revenue that is more than 685 million US dollar in 2016. The third rank of the list is Fuhua Tongda Agrochemical. It's a company based in China's Sichuan province, which climbed from the rank 20 in 2015 to the third rank in 2016 by increasing the revenue of pesticides from 240 million US dollar to 552 million US dollar. The first rank from 2015, Jiangsu Huifeng Agrochemical, fell down to the fifth rank in the list of 2016. When we're talking about the company analysis, I want to introduce you to the company research in CCM's platform. The company research function CCM's online platform shows the company portrait and matching of all the relevant market players in China's agrochemicals market. Users can see the five major public and private producers of a chosen commodity in the agrochemicals field. They will be default ranked by production. In five segments, with a whole list of enterprises, can be downloadable at the bottom. When choosing a company users want to analyze, it will reveal 12 segments that they can search. The financial info, the shareholder info, domestic sales of the company, export, production info, about the products, clients, suppliers, subsidiaries, snapshot news, news that are called from the internet, and finally the contact info. Now, let's have a look at the outlook for China's agrochemicals industry. From the future period of 2017 to 2022, 34 active ingredients in the agrochemical market will come off their patent. Those 34 agrochemicals are divided into 15 herbicides, 7 insecticides, 11 fungicides, and 1 safener. According to CCM, it might be only a matter of time for the second round of price hikes to arise throughout the Chinese pesticide technical market, given the tightening market supply, increasing global demand, and support from the new pesticide policies. The first quarter of 2017 saw surge prices for pesticides technical as increasing environmental pressure restrained the manufacturing of pesticide technical and the related intermediates. Yet, this uptrend didn't continue into the second quarter, since sales went flat and the prices of some products also slid. Furthermore, most pesticide technical sellers are now consuming their inventories. However, the market supply may not increase significantly in the second half, given the challenges brought by the new regulations on the pesticide administration, as well as environmental inspections conducted on a more regular basis in China. As the current inventories are depleted, it will be only a matter of time for the second round of price hikes to arise throughout the pesticide market, which is very likely to come in the fourth quarter of 2017, according to CCM. The environmental regulations have posed significant impacts on domestic pesticide industry in 2017. China's environmental policies always work well in regulating markets. Stringent administration helps cut out small-sized or even unlicensed producers and favors the development of leading enterprises. As their destocking comes to an end, these enterprises will soon start a new round of restocking, which is likely to boost the demand for pesticide exported from China. Particularly, as glyphosate-resistant weeds got wider spread, it is time for glyphosate-containing mixtures to take the center stage. Foreseeable, dicamba products will boom in the coming 3 years in China, according to CCM's research. Additionally, growth will be also seen in the glyphosate sales due to the ban of paraquat and the promotion of glyphosate plus glufosinate ammonium mixtures. Still, glyphosate products have great market potential given its high production technology thresholds and stable global production capacities in the coming 2 to 3 years. The new regulations on pesticide administration will benefit the leading pesticide manufacturers. Impacted by the agricultural supply side reform, the Chinese pesticide industry is estimated to record slight sales growth in the first half of 2017. Also, domestic pesticide industry kept its pace with the international market. In the short term, small and medium-sized pesticide producers will face heavy business pressure. There will be a tough process for them to transform into whole-course agricultural service providers or specialists in certain parts. However, the intensive policy update will better regulate the market and provide legal support to the sound and sustainable development of the entire industry, which can help improve production concentration and offer leading enterprises more business opportunities in the long run. Let's also have an outlook for fertilizers. For fertilizers, the practice of replacing chemical fertilizers with organic ones is expected to extend to the whole country after 2020, significantly decreasing the usage of chemical fertilizers. Some industry insiders have estimated how much chemical fertilizer usage will fall based on the data from the National Bureau of Statistics. In 2015, the amount of chemical fertilizers on fruits, vegetables, and tea was about 24 million tons, based on the total national usage, which was 60.23 million tons, which is a proportion of 40%. With the implementation of a new policy, the chemical fertilizer usage amount could be reduced by 5 million tons if a countrywide decrease of 20% in fruit, vegetable, and tea production areas is assumed. However, there are still many difficulties in the replacement of chemical fertilizers at the present, including the exact way how to replace it. According to experts, China produces about 16 million tons of commercial organic fertilizers, but only 5% of them are effective nutrients. In other words, there are effectively only 800,000 tons of nutrients in the present in the 16 million tons of commercial organic fertilizer, which is far less than the needed 5 million tons of chemical fertilizer. What's more, some regular organic fertilizers, such as chicken and pig manure, they contain high level of antibiotics, which may threaten the public health via the food chain. Reportedly, China's total organic fertilizer resources reached 70 million tons, and the current rate of use of these resources is only around 40%. At present, there are four main ways to utilize organic fertilizer resources nationally in China: straw incorporation, compost, commercial organic fertilizer, and green manure. It is currently unclear in which proportions these methods would replace chemical fertilizer. However, if more importance were placed on commercial organic fertilizer, China would likely achieve a large increase in the production of commercial organic fertilizer over the next few years. Okay, that brings us to the end of this webinar. Thank you very much all of you for attending. Please have a look at the recommended products and services of CCM and Trendanalysis I have mentioned. We like you to achieving your business goals in China with our market and trade research. Don't hesitate to contact your account manager or me and our team by email or phone to discuss the best solution for your needs in China's agrochemicals market. All of you have a great day, and hopefully see you again.